In this video, we review different types of faults in AC and DC grids. The main learning objectives will fall under three main questions. Firstly, what are the different types of faults in AC grids? Secondly, how is the fault current calculated for each type in the AC system? Thirdly, what are the different fault types in DC grids? In a three-phase system, various types of faults can occur between different phases and the ground. In the photo on the left, we show the arc flash between various phases and the ground in an overhead transmission line. In the photo on the right, we show the arc flash of the fault between two phases. In this video, we analyze three types of faults in an AC system. The first one is the single phase to ground type of fault. Typically, around 80% of the total faults in the electrical grids will fall in this category. The second type of fault can be the line-to-line fault, and the third type is the three-phase fault. In practice, around 5% of the total faults are three-phase. Next, we calculate the fault current for these three types of faults. Note that, for the sake of the simplification, in all the following calculations, we neglect the impedance of the lines. In other words, we only take into account the impedance of the fault. As mentioned, the most common type of fault is the line-to-ground one. In the figure, phase A is connected to the ground through the impedance ZF. We recall the video in the first week where the sequences of the three-phase systems were formulated. The zero, positive, and negative currents are obtained using the equation shown on the right. During the single phase to ground fault, obviously the values of the current of the phases B and C are zero. Then the values of the zero, I zero, positive, I positive, and negative currents, I minus, are obtained the same that are equal to 1/3 of the fault current, IA. The fault current can be calculated dividing the voltage of the phase A by the impedance of the fault ZF. Note that if the impedance of the lines is not neglected, then the fault current will be also a function of the zero, positive, and negative impedances of the line. In this slide, we show that how the inclusion of the line impedance makes the previous calculation more accurate for a line-to-ground fault. We represent the impedances by the positive sequence impedance, negative sequence impedance, and the zero sequence impedance. As we had obtained the zero sequence current equal to 1/3 of the fault current, in the equivalent circuit, the 3 times ZF appears. The zero sequence current can be then obtained dividing the voltage of phase A by the sum of the impedances Z plus, Z minus, and Z zero, and the 3 times of ZF. Finally, the fault current is obtained depending on the value of both line and fault impedances. Let's now analyze the line-to-line fault when phases B and C are connected together. In this case, first we show the voltage equations in the matrix representation. Then we replace the three-phase voltages A, B, and C with the zero, V0, positive, V positive, and negative, V negative voltages using the previously introduced sequence equation. The voltage difference between phases B and C is obtained depending on the positive and negative voltages. Finally, the fault current of phase B is obtained by the voltage of phase A, VA, multiplied by the square root of 3 divided by the fault impedance ZF. Let's now analyze the three-phase fault where it is assumed that the three phases are not connected to the ground. The circuit is shown in the figure on the left. VA, VB, and VC are the voltages of these three phases. IA, IB, and IC are also shown, the sum of which is equal to zero in this circuit. Using the previously introduced equation for the sequences, the zero, positive, and negative currents are shown here. Taking into account the previous two equations, the fault current of phase A, IA, becomes equal to positive current. The positive current can be obtained by the voltage of phase A divided by the fault impedance. The fault current of phases B and C are obtained with 240 and 120 degrees of the phase shift. Now let's have a look into the various types of faults in a DC grid. In the previous weeks, we had introduced three DC connection types of monopolar, bipolar, and homopolar types. Two types of fault can occur in these connections. The first one is the fault from the pole to the ground. In these cases, to simplify, the line impedance is neglected, and the fault DC current can be similarly calculated dividing by the DC voltage LVDC by the fault impedance ZF. In the bipolar and homopolar types, the second type of the fault can occur from one pole to the other pole. In this case, the voltage across the fault is equal to 2 times of LVDC. Therefore, the fault current is equal to 2 times of LVDC divided by fault impedance. In this video, we presented 3 types of faults in an AC system that are line to ground, line to line, and 3-line faults. We calculated the fault current for these 3 cases. We also showed 2 types of faults in DC grids, either pole to ground or pole to pole faults.